25 homes are confirmed to have been destroyed by the bushfires in the Grampians. Jordy Wright is in the fire zone, and Jordy, it's been a painful day for many out there.
Mitch, they've finally been allowed to go home, and for some, it's heartbreaking. One of the houses destroyed was at Dadswell Bridge, 24 others in the tiny town of Pomona. There's also been significant loss of stock, fence lines and sheds. Fire crews have spent the day dousing hotspots and working to make sure trees aren't about to come down. As the reality... Gemma Purcell has spent 4 years in Pomona building a business and becoming part of the local community.
Driving up there and looking, is it there? You know, gone, this house gone, the house at the back gone, and then the restaurant just saved.
A single building left standing at Windy Mist Mountain at Grampian Station.
Obviously, like the dwellings and things like that on the property, but more so the things you don't think about grabbing at last minute. That sort of stuff is what really kind of you think about. I think, you know, what is a home? It's not the four walls, it's the, I don't know, it's just the stuff inside, like the people, the memories.
A gateway town to the Grampians, tourists make this town tick. Colin McCaffer runs Barney's Bar and Bistro.
There's certainly a feeling of guilt on my part, you know, when I'm at the premises here that... You know, I've seen some of the places that have been affected and mine's fine. I think we just heard a tree go down there. So, yeah, the place is still not safe and it's getting there.
But the fire didn't discriminate.
It came down very, very quickly. There was nothing and then it just came down the valley.
We just saw it moving really quickly down the hill and then we're like, okay, this is really serious.
Almost $50,000 has already been raised to help rebuild the town, but it's just the beginning. Pomona's water supply isn't safe to drink, while Dadswell Bridge CFA volunteers are pleading with the Premier to help restore mobile phone services.
The first three conversations I had when I walked into the station was from members of the local community raising exactly this issue.
Immediate disaster payments of up to $2,200 are available for fire-affected families.